Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports.
Yes, indeed, it's Game On Fan Friday. We are definitely big on sports. Do remember, we are proudly powered by 1xBet. But we'll be talking rugby in just a bit. However, before we do that, there's two games to look out for tonight in the National Basketball League. In the men's side, the Betway Power Team will be up against the KU Titans. However, earlier in the evening, the side that is the JKL Lady Dolphins, the defending champions, will certainly be locking horns with the KCCA Leopards. Nick, big game in the women's side, KCC against JKL. What do you make of that game?
I'll tell you what, our two sides that for me will be title favourites. Of course, this promises to be a mouth-watering encounter. Ali Mavite's side is currently in a very, very fine form. I mean, when you look at the last five games, they've come out to win. Mox Sparks in Kumba, US Lady Cannons, yeah. My ABC A1 Challenge, the same A1 Challenge that came out not too long ago to actually end the JKL's unbeaten run. You want to think right now, KCC Leopards are in a good place, and that for me is momentum going into this game against the Lady Dolphins, who of course will be favorites on paper. Yeah. We talk about the experience that the Leopards possess. I mean, when you look at the names in there, Morena Modin, Martha Soyigi, Joy Chemutai, Irakunda, Cynthia, the Randis, Import, Judith Nansu, all these are match winners. And for some reason, for the last, I think, season or two, they haven't really delivered. Tonight will be a night they need to make a statement against the Lady Dolphins, and I want to believe that deciding the Dolphins are up for a very, very big outing. And of course, we can't, you know, help but talk about the fact that they possess the quality that's in the Dolphins. We talk about Zama, we talk about Evelyn Imani Shimwe, Nachitende, Brenda in there as well, Jamila Nancy Combi, among others. It's a side that is full of talent, I must say. But on paper right now, it's about Dolphins getting back to the race where they do belong in terms of winning. But as far as the Leopards are concerned, they might just want to come out and defy the odds and get a win. 2 points in the bag for them against the Dolphins.
Okay, Hope, on paper, the JKL Dolphins are the favorites, like he says. But we all know KCCA have got the pedigree, they've got the reputation. They are a powerhouse in women's basketball. Can the JKL Dolphins live up to the billing, or the KCL Leopards will defy the odds?
I think, for me to tell you the truth, JKL Dolphins are champions in waiting. Well, Nico has talked about, you know, how KCCA, you know, women have been, you know, very fantastic in the second round. They struggled a bit in the first round. And remember the first game, the opener was between JKL, where they beat, you know, KCCA women, and it was a very good result for them. I think coming into this game, they have that confidence that, you know, we have that advantage over you. We have the confidence. We have tried beating you once, and it could be the second time. They have lost one game. I talked about it, you know, against A1 Challenge, but I still feel both teams are good on paper, you know, fighting. If KCCA beat, you know, JKL, that means they'll be topping their log on they're on 13 wins right now. Can JKL Fields have, you know, 15 wins and just one loss? So I think it's going to be a very fantastic, you know, match to look out for. But whoever comes out organized, because both teams have been good in the second round, and that's why I think it's going to be a very good match to look out for, you know.
We also question the ability, the shooting ability of the KCCA Leopards. In the first round, we saw how the Lady Dolphins managed to run over the Leopards, because then they had the cutting edge from downtown. You saw how Zama actually played around that area just to get 20-plus baskets on the night. So double figures for me will speak tonight. Sure. Who actually comes out on top, especially going into the third and fourth quarter, where it does matter, because, again, the Leopards tend to choke when it matters most. And tonight, the best team will, of course, come out. And those nitty-gritties, those small areas might just be the key areas in terms of who gets to win. But for me, I think it's about Dolphins coming out and try to pick up where they left off. I know the defeat against A1 Challenge was quite heartful, but moving forward, they should get the win tonight against the Leopards.
Okay, let's talk the men's game though. KU Titans against Betway Power, another interesting game. Power were blown away in the first round when they played against the KU Titans. So much has happened ever since. They've had a mixed start the second round. They've got two of their most important players, handed suspensions in there, including the main man, Geoffrey Sora, and Philippa Meni. Who comes out on top tonight?
Well, it's a very huge setback for Arnold Lando, having missing out those two big boys in Ameni and, of course, Geoffrey Sora, formerly at KU Titans. One thing, Warriors right now should be in a much big position, even a good position to actually get all 2 points against Power. Power had their own, you know, wagons right from the first round. We saw how badly they started, and then eventually finishing, sixth place in the first round, going into the second round. Having come out with, three wins in the last five games, you want to think tonight they might have to redeem themselves against Warriors. A Warriors side that, for me, are in a very good position to get a win tonight against a wounded Power side in terms of lacking their big boys in Ameni and, of course, Geoffrey Soro. But it should be an evenly poised encounter, of course, given that Power are title favorites, haven't lived up to that for the last three seasons. Warriors, on the other hand, have been that sleeping giant. So you might want to put into consideration the Warriors right now might be in a much better position to get a win against Power.
Hope, you look at these two sides. You look at KU Titans. If I'm not mistaken, they should be bottom of the log for the main side in the second round. Five games played, they've lost four. They've only been able to pick up one win. On their side, Betway Power fourth on the log for the second round. Six games, four wins, and two losses in there. Who comes out on top tonight?
I think it has to be Betway Power. Of course, both teams are struggling. They're both wounded. But if you look at the both teams on paper, I think Betway Power have the catching edge. They've won their last two games against, you know, Falcons and Ndeja University.
Yep.
For KU Titans, it's a different story. They've had issues. They've been poor defensively and offensively. Most of the players have not, you know, they have failed to be consistent in most of the games. I think it has really affected them so much. For Betway, I think it's just attitude and discipline in the team. You talked about Philip Amani and, you know, Geoffrey Soro. These are the best players. If you have your best players, well, I think they should be the pillar of inspiration to other players in the team. Mm. And you're behaving like that, most especially when you're playing against your rival. That was against the Warriors. The last game at, you know, YMCA. So I think there's a lot to look out for, you know, in this game. And for me, if Power, they win this game, it will be a good game to boost their confidence. And another thing, of course, I talked about most of their players, but they still have enough quality in their team, you know, to upset KU Titans.
Would it be an upset, though? I mean, even then, you'd want to think that Warriors right now should be in the winning bubble. But you mentioned something in there about player management. I mean, Arnold Lando is not the biggest of coaches, so he wouldn't make a lot of noise to actually...
He's also not one of the most experienced, really.
So I would want to think that he has failed to handle some of those big names.
Big heads.
That for me is a minus, because if you have such big, prolific names in your team, you've got to find ways of managing them accordingly. And that is something he's failed to do. We've seen this with Mandy Giruni back in the days with the Kami Kabanges, with all these big stars in that squad. But he did manage to, you know, he tried, actually. Not even trying, he actually did quite a good job in terms of handling them.
Working
so for Coach Arnold Lando, that is something he's got to work on moving forward, and even then, avoiding such, you know, bad behaviors from his team.
Okay, certainly the Lady Rugby Cranes, as we speak, are currently down in South Africa as they get ready for their first game in the 2021 Rugby World Cup qualifiers. Well, they'll be up against the host South Africa later this particular afternoon, and then next week on Tuesday, they'll play their second game against the Kenyan Lionesses before they wrap it up on Saturday next week against Madagascar. Do remember, it's a four-team qualifiers. The team that comes out on top out of the three games will certainly be representing the continent in 2021. That is at the Women's Rugby World Cup. So, hey, for the Lady Cranes, it looks like it's quite the mountain to climb, coming up against Kenya, South Africa, and the emerging force in Madagascar.
A big task, for, you know, for the ladies, and I mean, it's their first time, and these are the ladies who have not been in action for a while. They just played, I think, two games last month, and then they're coming to
a very competitive qualifiers.
So I think, you just have to be patient and see, like the coach talked about it, you know, it's a work in progress, and we're just going to see what they're going to do. They're going to play against, you know, tough opponents, Kenya, Zimbabwe. And is it Namibia?
Madagascar.
These are teams who have been involved in rugby for a very long time, and then you're going to face them. So I think we just have to wait and see what they do, but we wish them all the best.
Well, tell you what, I hate to rub it in their faces, but this could be like more of a tour of experience for them in terms of going out there, get a feel of what it's like to play at that stage. We know it's their first time playing the qualifiers. The back-to-back defeats against Kenya for me were just a butchering of some sort, and I thought maybe lessons were picked up from that. You know, back-to-back defeats. I want to believe that they will go out there and try to, you know, compete favorably. But of course, you know, you can't say they are favorites, because they are not favorites against top sides like South Africa, recently Kenya. Now they're back in their faces. There could be a double nightmare or a triple nightmare if they don't get a result this coming weekend. But I want to believe what the team have achieved from the Women's Elgin Cup going forward. A bit of motivation in there, a couple of big names as well, as far as experience gets to go.
Yeah.
A win against South Africa, I don't see that coming. Against Kenya, maybe, because this is familiar territory. Madagascar, again, for me, it's not going to happen. So them qualifying for the forthcoming Women's Rugby World Cup, set to happen in New Zealand, is far from far from their faces in terms of them trying to reach the global stage. But as of now, it is just experience. Go out there, have some fun, play some nice rugby, and then see where it actually lands you.
Okay, certainly that is the Rugby Lady Cranes. We want to wish them the best of luck as they head into those qualifiers. as they do kick off today, and they'll be down in South Africa for the next 1 week or so. But hey, before we get into that break, there's a bit of football as well that does kick off this weekend. That is the FUFA Super 8 tournament, and it's the side Vipers that will be up against Mbarara City in what promises to be a very exciting game of football. The first of two semi-finals next week, KCCA will be in action as well, as they'll be up against Ondo Paraka. Hope, I'll start with you. Vipers having had a brilliant outing against Poland. You look at, you know, the side Mbarara City as well, knocking out URA, if I'm not mistaken. And it looks like it's a battle for a place in the finals between these two teams.
I think for me, the difference between Vipers and Mbarara City, Vipers have been busy in the market, buying every player, everyone who has a good name on paper. Mm. They bought Aaron Kaiwa, I think, should be involved in this game. Dennis, who saw him last time.
Rashid Toha,
but I think he's going to miss this game. Dennis scored that solo goal against Poraline, yes. Yeah. So I think they still have enough. They have the experience, but they lost most of their good players, most especially in the midfield. Moses Weiss, Tadeo Ranga. It could affect them somehow, but the likes of Siraj Sentamu, he had a very good debut against Proline, and I think he should be putting out the same, you know, performance against Mbarara City. So I think for Mbarara City, of course, we all know it, the man should be looking out for. You know, in every big occasion, you want the best players to be showing up. Paul Mucherezi has been their treasured asset since he joined from KCCA. And the likes of Henry Mukundane, these are the players that, you know, really need to improve a lot and continue with the performance they had last season. Both of the teams have different management from the one we had last season. Mbarara City, Babas is out of the team, so you expect, you know, Robert to have a very hard job to do, stepping in the shoes of Charles Babas. Brian Senyondo. Mm-hmm. So I think it's going to be a very tough game for both teams, but I still feel like Vipers have that cutting edge in this game.
Two things for me here: bragging rights. The other beat was, of course, the last time the two sides faced off. It was Mbarara City with the final say. But you want to think that Vipers right now are in a rebuilding stage in terms of trying to get themselves ready for the new coming season. We know they haven't played that much preseason football, and that for me will also be a count in terms of how far they can actually go this coming season. But if yes, they're up against Mbarara City, a very, very good side. They've actually managed to build themselves right from last season. Paul Mucherezi, like she mentions, has been the X factor for them as far as their game gets to go. Tonight could be a win for Mbarara City. And who knows, maybe Vipers could actually come out and try to win something for themselves in preseason going into next season.
Okay, that is my bit of football for you, the FUFA Super 8 tournament. But hey, let's get into a break now. When we come back after the break, we'll be talking the two sides that will be representing Uganda on the continent. KCCA are currently down in Namibia. They'll be up against African Stars in the CAF Confederations Cup qualifiers. And then Proline, yes, they'll be hosting Masters Security Services from Malawi this weekend at the StarTime Stadium in Lugogo. Also, a little later on in the show, we'll be talking everything to do with the transfer service. Some really big moves yesterday on transfer deadline day. And then the English Premier League kicks off tonight. It's Liverpool that will be up against Norwich City at the Anfield. So that and so much more when we do come back after the break. It's Game On, and this is Fan Friday.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports.